Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Clemson Tigers and the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. And as we get set to tip off, let's take a look at two of the players we'll be following tonight. And of course, our starting lineup.
Matchup at the small forward position should be intriguing. These guys can get it done at the wing position, whether attacking the basket or shooting from the perimeter. Must give these guys close attention.
And before we tip off, let's see what these two sides are going to be focusing on today. And after all that anticipation, we're underway. They've worked the perimeter. He fires away. He can't get it to go.
It's mine.
The Tigers motion for a round one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
Out on the wing. In the lane.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Rath, they've got him right where they want him. They work it around the perimeter. Shots up. Shots off. Nice low post play. Good entry down into the box. You've got to be prepared when you go up against this team, Raph. Their pressure can be relentless at times. They love to pressure you full court.
Well, you're right on top of that, Gus. They really like to force you into mistakes with their pressure.
Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Rafter. Look at the crowd, Raph. Talk about home court advantage. Talk about a tough place to play. They're on their feet. And to shoot now. With a big shot. Can't connect from the three-point line. Pushes it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. And he lays it up and in. Now that's taking it strong to the rim, isn't it?
That's a great take. Strong to the tin. That puts incredible pressure on the D when you go to the hoop like that.
And we're going the other way. How about a second time? Check out this layup.
How about the concentration at the tin, despite being banged in the paint?
Out on the left wing. He tries the three. Well, coach, is a timeout forthcoming?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there, Gus. They're really out of sync.
That's charging.
A classic case of a player trying to do too much, Gus. He forced the issue there.
The Tigers now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating the pinch, and then find the open guy.
Harrison receives the ball. Turnover. They'll go the other way. Timeout on the floor, ladies and gentlemen. More CBS Sports coverage after this. And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Demon Deacons running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
On the low block. Jump shot. It's almost like there's a lid on the basket. They're having a tough time with these rims.
They can't get anything to drop. These guys have hit rock bottom. Their confidence at the moment couldn't be any lower.
On the left side. From the corner, the senior. The Tigers seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
He makes the block. Shots off. Hungry for the ball. Pushes it. In the lane.
How about that, huh?
He's a good inside presence who can step out to the perimeter and knock it down.
Mr. Versatility, when you have a big guy who can score in, step out deep, and knock it down, it just opens up so many other things for the offense, the ability to slip others into the box area.
On the wing. Shots up, no luck from downtown. Out on the left wing. And we'll get a change of possession. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, guys. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
He looks for three, but he misses his block. Loose ball kept in. Shots off. Pulls it in. On the left side. He attempts the three. Comes up empty from deep.
Get out and fill.
Williams handles the pass. Right where they want him, Raph. On the right side.
How about that elevation?
The Tigers are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game, really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
In the lane. Off the mark.
What a rebound. I own it.
Cross court. Fires.
How about that, Gus?
We're at the 8-minute mark. Out on the way. Heat check time from long range. He puts it up quick to beat the clock and misses.
And he looks to outlet.
Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. On the low block. No good. 7 minutes left on the game clock. Williams receives the pass. In the lane.
It's good.
He goes for three. With no luck.
Great strength.
Thomas handles the feed. Jump shot. Shots off. Give it here. They work it around the perimeter. He fires it up. No.
Oh, physicality.
We are at the 6 minute mark. On the right side. Shots off.
I own it.
The senior commits the turnover. The Demon Deacons in a hurry. Down the lane.
Finger roll. So easy for this guy.
They're going to call that a backcourt violation.
You've got to think. You've got to limit those moments.
You know, Raph, this guy has really elevated his game today.
He's been excellent, Gus. He's seemed really focused coming into this game, and he's shining. Has almost single-handedly put his team in a position to win this game. On it.
The Tigers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand.
He rejects it. The Demon Deacons on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
We're at the 5 minute mark. Ah, he got it up and in. Now that's taking it strong to the rim, isn't it?
That's a great take. Strong to the tin. That puts incredible pressure on the D when you go to the hoop like that.
Nice pass to the low block. In the lane. Coach, these guys are really struggling here tonight.
Having a tough time finding the goal. Not a great performance here tonight, Gus.
Can finish. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Timeout call. We'll get you back into the action right after this. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. The Tigers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Looking for a good shot. The ball carrier can't escape.
Great defensive trap there. That's almost textbook, Gus.
Tipped in.
What a great tip in. You've got to applaud that second effort.
The Tigers and now getting set up four around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
And another miss. They can't get anything to fall.
You know, they got to find a way to get some good looks and get something going to the 10.
On the left side, dials up a long-range shot. Not this time.
Strong rebound. And he bangs it down.
Low block. Fires.
How about this kid, huh?
The Tigers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
He tries to beat the buzzer, and no! He gets it back. He missed it.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner, and he can't get the bounce. Now they work it around the perimeter. He takes the three. Bucket. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Feed the low post. Jump shot. And answer. The Tigers are looking to force the tempo now by extending their defense.
Well, Gus, forcing the opposition to play 94 feet is ideal if they can't play the full court game.
Big shot. Buckets. We are at the 1 minute mark. Looking for the bomb. Can't connect from the 3-point line. When you talk about home court advantage and great atmosphere, you can't help but think of this court and these fans.
These are some of the most passionate fans in college basketball. There are not too many other sports where you can get commitment like this from your supporters. It is just great to see and be a part of.
He shoots from the corner. The sophomore. The Tigers look like they want to use their defense to speed up the tempo in this game.
While pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the personnel, Gus. Otherwise, it's an ill-advised play on the defensive end. You've got to know your strengths and stick to them.
Fires. And hits. The Tigers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
Stay tuned for the road to the Final Four. A look at how the numbers stack up for each team here today. We can see here how both teams are doing with the keys they identified at the outset.
They come out in a minimum.
jump shot. He can't get it to go. Inside. This guy is a complete player in the post.
The big fella. He can beat you face up or back to the basket. He can step out a few feet and knock it down, Gus. He's just a tough, tough matchup.
The Tigers now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep ball.
Shots off.
That's exactly what coaches love to see from their D. After shots gone up, a great checkout and rebound.
Out on the wing. He puts up the tray.
Perfect.
Top of the key. He shoots from the corner. No luck from downtown. Takes the pass in the paint.
How about that? Huh?
Tigers seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
Up and in. Ha ha! Now they work it around the perimeter. Shots up. No!
Great inside control.
They work the perimeter. And he lays it up and in. Defender right up on the ball. Takes the medium range jump shot. The sophomore. The Tigers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
The Tigers running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Cross court. He unloads a three. Nice. In the lane. And hits. The Tigers motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
They work it around the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Up it inside. He manages to keep it in. And the ball is out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. Rapid's been a great team effort for these guys.
Everyone has been getting involved, Gus. Unselfish play, getting timely defensive stops, and really good execution at the offensive end.
Thank you. with the big shot. But he misses his target. In the post. Fires. Off the mark.
See, reacting. How alert, Gus.
Got it in the low block. Jump shot. No.
Oh, what a good rebound there, Gus. You got to secure those ones. The more rebounds you get, obviously, the better.
On the outside.
Put a little English on it.
The Tigers are making an adjustment defensively. Looks like they're going to apply additional pressure defensively.
It's a great decision if you have the players to play full court pressure defense, Gus. You need stamina, though. It's not an easy defense to play for extended periods of time.
On the wing. Fires. He missed it.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Tup it inside. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Way out on the right wing. And he hits it. We're getting a good taste of what home court advantage is. This crowd has been outstanding.
When this crowd is at its best, this is definitely one of the toughest places to play. Almost impossible for away teams to come in here and get a victory.
The Tigers running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
On the outside. He attempts the trifecta.
Big-time dagger.
We've got a timeout. More CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball right after this. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Demon Deacons now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Looking for a good shot. Around 8 minutes remaining. The Demon Deacons can't find the basket at all, Coach.
You know, they're really not taking advantage of their opportunities. No legs left, Gus.
Comes up empty from deep. The Demon Deacons on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
They work it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. Nice block. Dump it inside. He shoots from outside and misses.
An offensive rebound is such a lift to the team.
Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Raph. He can't beat the trap.
What a great job of containing the ball handler there, Gus.
They keep him under wraps.
Great defensive trap there. That's almost textbook, Gus.
Why don't we check in on tonight's key performers, Coach?
There are a lot of things that don't always show up in the stat sheet, Gus. These guys could have a horrible game up to this point, so long as they step up and make the big play when called upon.
7 minutes left on the game clock. Jump shot. And he can't get the bottom. Rejected. Change of possession. Made this long-range shot look easy.
Great stroke. Magnificent.
That finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Baseline inbound. On the right wing. Up and in. That was a great delivery on the back door.
Gusto's bang bang plays, they're fun to watch and even more fun to pull off.
They work it around the perimeter. He can't get it to go.
That's exactly what coaches love to see from their D. After shots gone up, a great checkout and rebound.
We are at the six-minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. Fires. Answer. Shots off. Snatches the ball. He shoots from the corner, and he gets it. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. The Tigers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
The team and Deacons are really doing a good job running their offense.
Gosh, you know, this game can be so simple when you do it right. Balance on the floor, making the right pass, and shooting high percentage shots.
A great trap initiated by the defense. Defense! Defense! 5 minutes left on the game clock. He fires from long range.
Dagger!
The Tigers in their 4-round-1 motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Get it down on the low block. Jump shot. He nails the bucket. Raf, if the butterflies aren't going right now, there's something wrong with you.
This one can go either way, Gus. Who's going to step up and make the big play? These close games are part of the reason why I got out of coaching. The tension is just too much. Unbearable. You've got to love it, Gustavo.
4 minutes left on the game clock. And he can't hit the shot. Ah, he got it up and in. Out on the wing. With the big shot, he drains the bucket. On the right side. Swatted away.
Oh, what a good rebound there, Gus. You got to secure those ones. The more rebounds you get, obviously, the better.
We're at the 3 minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. Turnover by the senior. Way out on the right wing. Fires. No. On the right side. He tries to beat the clock. It won't fall. Pushes it. Left on the game clock. On the inside. He shoots from the top of the circle. He gets that one to fall. Lobs it. They work it around the perimeter.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Thomas on the move. Can't get it to go. Got it. Wow. Dump it inside. He shoots from the corner. He can't get the bucket to fall. Minute remaining. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Jump shot. Drains it. The Tigers seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
The shot won't fall. And he misses the shot. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Tigers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Cross court. He shoots from the deep corner. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots. And not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
Now it's just a matter of clock management, isn't it, Coach?
This is where your point guard becomes very important. Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
I think that's it, Bill.
That's his last personal. We'll have to go without his services for the rest of the game.
Foul. And that stops the clock again. And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not? Gus, without a doubt, this will be an emotional year for him. But the key is to stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time to reflect at the end of the season. His team needs him to perform at his best now.
Rims out.
What a coach will be happy with that.
And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Tigers working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
And put it down. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key to any successful program.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. Tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout. He dials from long distance. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Let's check in and have a look at our players of the game.
They were both great here today, Gus. Both ends of the court. I'm certain that they'll be happy with their performances.
That concludes our coverage on CBS Sports. For the Governor, Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson saying good night.